Just guide the youngsters and the adults so that they understand that they must only wash that which is beneficial. They must only wash that which is going to give them the sunnah in their lives. Put ikhlas in your life. Put sincerity in your life. This can be a way of making sure that people understand the deen Islam. The legacy of Muhammad who always live. The Quran is giving us good news. Good news that guides us in this universe and the hereafter, brothers and sisters.
A'udhu billahi minash shaitan rajim. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Rabbi shrah li sudri wassir li amri. وَحْلُ غُلَةً مِنْ لِسَانِ يَفْقَهُ قَوْلِي. Brothers and sisters in Islam, welcome to our beautiful topic today, which is called Palestine. Brothers and sisters in Islam, whenever we hear about the word Palestine, many people think about war. Many people think about those images, that heart-touching images that we see on the televisions. Brothers and sisters in Islam, there's more into Palestine. Mainly also, is it has got one of the holiest prayer sites, which is called Masjid Aqsa. Let us look at what Allah says in the Quran about Masjid Aqsa. بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم سبحان الذي أسرى بعبده ليلا من المسجد الحرام من المسجد الحرام من المسجد الحرام إلى المسجد الأقصى الذي باركنا حوله لنريه من آياتنا إنه هو السميع البصير. That glory be to the one who took his servant on a journey by night from Masjid Haram, Makkah, to Masjid Aqsa, whose precincts or whose surrounding is blessed. So brothers and sisters in Islam, let us be mindful here that Palestine holds one of the holiest places in the world. So let us be mindful also to the fact that the Muslims, before they used to, or when they used to worship, they used to face Palestine. So let us be mindful that as Muslims, let us respect what the Quran says. And does not mean that when Muslims talk about Palestine, it does mean that it means that maybe they hate the Jews. The Muslims do not hate the Jews at all. The Muslims have got a lot of respect for the Jews. The Muslims have got respect for all human races in the world. So brothers in Islam, let us be mindful that Bayt al-Maqdis in Palestine was the two end established mosque established after Masjid Haram. It was the two end, just imagine. And Bayt al-Maqdis is Palestine was the first Qibla direction in entire Meccan period of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So then after Allah ordered the Qibla to be changed towards the Kaaba or in Mecca. So this shows the significance or the importance of Masjid Aqsa. So brothers and sisters in Islam, prayers in Masjid Aqsa are equivalent to 500 times the prayers in any other mosque besides Masjid Haram in Makkah and Masjid Nabawi. So look at the blessings that you get from performing Salah in Masjid Aqsa. So brothers in Islam, let us look at the history of Palestine. Several Quranic verses in the Hadith talk about Palestine. The history of Palestine represents from the time of Adam alayhi salam, the first man to be created by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The holy site where prophets were born or died, including Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam, Prophet Lut alayhi salam, Prophet Dawood alayhi salam, Prophet Suleiman alayhi salam, and Prophet Musa alayhi salam, and Prophet Isa alayhi salam. So brothers in Islam, Dawood alayhi salam and Suleiman alayhi salam were able to create Islamic states in Palestine. So it is very, very important for us to remember one point here, that Masjid Aqsa has got one of the greatest importance. It's actually a great example in the society of the Muslims of how the Islamic history, has survived for so many years. The Islamic history has been there for so many years in this universe, mostly in Palestine. So you and me, let us remember one point. Masjid Aqsa was the site of Isra, the Mi'raj, during the period of Meccan period for the message of Nabi Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, which was passed to Nabi Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. The message of Islam, the message of how many salahs that you have to perform. So basically, the Mi'raj, all the Muslims are familiar to what is called the Mi'raj. So the ascension to heaven, this is what? This is the site from Bayt al-Maqdis. So brothers and sisters in Islam who are out there, let us be mindful that as Muslims, we have to respect and love the fact that Palestine is one of the holiest lands for the Muslim world. At the same time, it does not mean that if Muslims strive for Palestine, it means that they hate other communities or they hate other Jews. But the fact that this is a holiest place and the land belongs to the Palestinians, it belongs to the Muslims. So Palestine was brought under Muslim control during the time of Umar ibn Khattab, the Khalifa, and the Khalifa of the Muslims. So that means that the whole section was a place where there are so many Muslims that lived for so many years in Palestine. So brothers and sisters in Islam, up till today, you find that in Gaza, the places where you find a lot of scholars of Islam, you find them in areas like Gaza. So it's very important for us as Muslims to respect the fact that Palestine holds a significant factor or a significant point in the history of Islam. And in 1187, Palestine was liberated by the Muslims under the leadership of what? Salahuddin. So this all shows the beauty or the greatness of this land called Palestine. And in 1917, the British governor issued the Balfour Declaration, which declared Palestine to be a homeland for the Jews. And at that time, the Jews were only 8% and only 2.5% of the land. But look at what is happening today. I was watching a documentary which was done by a Jew American who is actually supporting the cause of the Palestinian. He said that land is being annexed or taken each and every day from Palestine, and which is painful. So brothers and sisters in Islam, really, this pains the heart that other human beings have been staying a long time in a certain place, and this type of apartheid, this type of hate happens, that their land is taken. Just like what was happening in South Africa with the apartheid. The African people, they were staying for a long time. But after some time, when apartheid came, they started to be segregated. As I speak today, in Palestine, there are walls which are being built. But look at it. We are all sons of Adam. And our mother is what? Is Hawa, alayhi salam, or Eve. But look at how other human beings are segregating each other. In Palestine, there are so many walls that are being built. Just imagine, so that other human beings cannot see what is happening. And some of the walls are being built on Palestinian land. Just like what has happened in South Africa, the apartheid that was happening, that even if you want to travel to the Eastern Cape, you have to carry what are called dumpers or passports to pass these areas. So which is painful. So just imagine you're in your own country, but you have to use a passport to pass to another place. So it's happening currently. I'm talking about 24 now. That people are using passports or they're using documents. Sometimes even they say that the road, when they're using the road, there's a road for Palestinians and there's a road for Israelis. Really, it's unfair because we are all human beings. So the pain of Palestine is really traumatic to all human beings, such that the cause of the Palestinians is not only touched the hearts of the Muslims alone. You will find that there are doctors that are coming from different parts of the world, just coming to hear the plight or to save the sufferings of the Palestinians. We all heard about ships that are coming with food aid to save or to give the people of Palestine. So you and me, brothers and sisters in Islam, let us feel the pain of the Palestinians. Today, if you have no ability to give the Palestinian any food, try to pray for them. Life is too short. Kullu nafsin dha'iqatul maut. That every human being on earth will taste death. So you and me, before we taste our death, let us remember one point. Let us save humanity. Saving Palestine also is saving humanity. The people of Palestine must be always in our prayers, must be always in our duas, because they are being bombarded. Those people, they live life which is so hard. Sometimes they don't even have electricity. And look at the resources that we have in our societies. We're able to get water, to get electricity. Life is very easy. But for Palestinians, life is so hard. So brothers and sisters in Islam, you will find that the Palestinians, they don't want war, but they just want to live in peace in their areas. But what happens is that a certain group of people, they go and attack them. And this topic and speech of today does not mean that Islam is a religion of hate or religion of terrorism. But Islam is a religion of clarification of the truth, the religion of authenticity, the religion of Nabi Muhammad SAW. So let's understand the point that even Mandela cried tears that Palestine is not free. That means in the world, we're not free. Imagine the status of Mandela, how it was. But Mandela also resonated with his words about the pain of Palestine. A man who spent 27 years in prison. So I urge whoever is watching today that feel the pain of the Palestinians. Feel the pain of Gaza. What is going on in Gaza. And may Allah make it easy for the Atfal. Allahumma tahiru qulban wa ninfaq. Allahumma, Allahumma ansuru Atfal fi Palestine. May Allah make it easy for the Atfal, the children. The children in Palestine, they live in such poverty. They live in pain. Every day they're hearing bombs. Sometimes if you look at the images, they are so heart-touching. Sometimes you look at the images of children that were bombed, no legs, no eyes, no head. Brothers and sisters in Islam, this is reality. These are not words from my mouth. Look at the images. You can Google Palestine pain or Palestine atrocities. You will find that Palestinians are dying in a very drastic way, in a very painful way. So you and me today, the cause of Palestine or the pain of Palestine, we must also feel it in the heart. So brothers and sisters in Islam that are watching this topic today of Palestine, let us make sure that you sit down and you wait, inshallah, for the next segment of our episode today, which is called Palestine. So inshallah, we're taking a short break and we're coming back after the break. We must want to make it easy for us to remember and to make dua for the people of Palestine. Assalamu alaikum.
Let's guide the youngsters and the adults so that they understand that they must only watch that which is beneficial. They must only watch that which is going to give them the sunnah in their lives. Put ikhlas in your life. Put sincerity in your life. This can be a way of making sure that people understand the deen Islam, the legacy of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, who always lived. The Quran is giving us good news. Good news that guide us in this universe and the hereafter, brothers and sisters.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Brothers and sisters in Islam, welcome back to a beautiful topic today, which is called Palestine. Brothers and sisters in Islam, whenever we hear about the word Palestine, we all feel the pain in our hearts. So let's look at the historical figures about the pain of Palestine. In 1918, the British campaigned to immigrate European Jews to Palestine. That was in 1918. And in 1914, the Jews claimed themselves land of Palestine and called it Israel. That is in 1948. Thousands of Muslims were forced out of Palestine under military pressure of Jewish terrorist groups. Just look at the pain. You had your land. Maybe you built a home. Beautiful house. Suddenly someone says, no, this is not your house. Get out. We're taking the land away from you. Like what happened in South Africa. We hear the stories in Cape Town where people were staying and then suddenly the land is taken from them. Look at colonization itself. Colonization did the same thing. So basically, brothers and sisters in Islam, we live in one world, one earth. We are one human. No one is better than the other. No one can say, I got my own world or my own oxygen. We all go to the toilet. We all use the same oxygen. That's oxygen. We all drink water. So basically, we are one human race. Forget racism. Forget tribalism. We are one. So why you have to take another person's land? Why you have to take another person's morsel of food? Share the food. That is the plight of the Palestinians. And in 1967, Israel attacked Egypt, Jordan, and Syria, and occupied more land, including Masjid Aqsa. That was in 1967. So brothers and sisters in Islam, to date, from 1948 to 1914, thousands of Palestinians have been killed by the Jews. Only this year, brothers in Islam, you all remember those boys that were playing by the beachfront, how they were bombed, the images, heart-touching images of those boys that were killed in Gaza. This is very painful. You all remember the women crying when all those buildings, dilapidated buildings. Yes, they can say there's some missiles coming from Gaza, but they don't reach the points. You find that some people, they only use tons. When their land is being occupied, they come with guns. Palestinians don't have those guns. And they just go, leave the land and they go, because they're scared to just die. So this is what is happening. Let us out there understand that Islam is not a religion of hate. Inna deena inda Allahil Islam. Surely Islam is a religion of what? Of peace. And the deen to Allah, the deen to the Creator is a religion of peace. This is the same religion of Jesus, peace be upon him. This is the same religion of Joseph, peace be upon him. This is the same Islam, the religion of what? Of Ibrahim, alayhi salam. This is the same religion of Moses, peace be upon him. This is not an innovated religion. But this religion has been there. Even Adam, alayhi salam, was what? Was a Muslim. So Islam means peace within yourself, peace with the Creator and all what is near you. If maybe the Israelis wanted the land, why not share? Why not love each other? Why not share and love each other? They say in English, sharing is caring. Now, why kill the human race, brothers and sisters in Islam, if you see the images that are coming from Gaza, you will have to cry tears. If you can't give a rand or a dollar to Palestine, shed tears, because it's painful. Imagine what was happening during the apartheid era. The pain the people felt. How was it? It was very traumatic. Today, when some people think about the pain that they felt in Palestine, they cry tears. People living 27 years in prison. 27 years, just imagine. Someone who's 24, 27 years is an adult, but somebody lived in prison those years. Today as I speak, they say that in Palestine, men, young boys are taken to prison. Young boys. Sometimes they were just throwing stones, playing, my child is your child. This is the global motto of the world. My child is your child. Then that child is taken into prison. How is that child going to cope in prison? This is happening in Palestine. Brothers and sisters in Islam, this is why, yes, we can say we're donating money, we're donating food, but let's understand the reality. Let's call on our Jews to tell them the truth that they should care and love other human race. Yes, I know out there, like the sister I was talking about, an American Jew, but she goes to Gaza. She goes and see the reality and help the people of what? Of Gaza. So we have to care and love one another. And I know there are some many Jews that care for the people of Gaza and people of Palestine. So brothers and sisters in Islam, what about the others? So let's come as human race, as what? As the children of Adam, and stop the atrocities. Stop punishing the human race. The people of Gaza are in pain. Look at a mother who would give birth in the hospital and bombs are airing from all over. Look at a mother who is giving birth plus she's in pain. Maybe she lost her foot. Maybe she lost her hand during the bombing. How much pain she feels. Look at a man, like one man was saying, I worked for so many years, but my company has been destroyed. I now don't have my company. I saw a mother. When I mean a mother, I don't mean a mother of 25 years old or 20 years old. I mean an old mother crying tears that I don't have a place to stay. My place has been taken. We saw, brothers and sisters in Islam, how the border posts are controlled, such that you find people staying for days trying to go to a certain area to see their relatives. Brothers and sisters in Islam, imagine me, I build a wall for my neighbor. to build a wall for my neighbor. They say in English, love thy neighbor. Love your neighbor. The Quran says this, Qurba. Even the Bible says, love your neighbor. So which book are they reading? Even Musa alayhi salam, the prophet of Islam, whom we call Moses, loved all human beings. He never was racist. He never was tribalistic. Musa alayhi salam had no apartheid. Musa alayhi salam taught peace. So which peace are they teaching people by building a wall? Why the wall? We're not all human beings. We're not all creatures of Adam, peace be upon him. So Islam is a religion which loves everybody. Even in an Islamic state, it's allowed for Christians to be with Muslims. It's allowed for Jews to be there. During the time of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his uncles were not Muslims. But he was living in the same area with them and teaching them and reminding them that come to Islam. There was a delegation which was sent to Ethiopia, which was called Abyssinia. The delegation was Muslim. And from Saudi Arabia, they went to Ethiopia to the Christians. And one king by the name of Najashi, he embraced Islam. So Islam is not a religion of hating Christians. Islam does not allow hating of anyone's religion. But it allows you to do da'wah and to respect other fellow human beings. So why is it that these other Jews are failing to do likewise? Brothers in Islam, I think they should emulate the African-American sister, the American sister who is Jew. She, with the plight and pain that she saw from the people of Palestine, she went to see it with her own eyes in Gaza, how they're feeling the pain. So you and me, likewise, if we've got the ability, let us actually lobby for Israel to stop what it's doing, to come back to the love that Musa alayhi salam had. Musa alayhi salam had a lot of love. He had no hate. You can't tell me today, if someone throws a stone to you, you throw back a big stone to that person. No. If your friend throws stones to you, you throw back apples. Throw back apples, not a big stone. Likewise, there will be peace. Now, if you say, no, I'm the boss, and you destroy everybody, this is not right. Let us remember, if you're Jewish, you're listening out there, I love you. Think about the consequences, the aftermath of what you're doing today. Respect fellow human beings. I respect you. Respect human life. Let us stop the apartheid. Let us think about the pain that the prisoners are feeling. Forgive each other. Those prisoners that are in prison for no reason, take them out. Forgive and forget. Why can't we appreciate the world that we're living as a human race? When we're all Bani Adam. Bani Adam means we're all sons and daughters of Adam. Peace be upon him. Now I'm going to read a short poem on Gaza, which says, Gaza, they pained you. They destroyed you. Gaza, you are the apple tree, the apple of my eyes. I see. Gaza, I see your tears when you bleed. Gaza, I see your tears when you shed tears. Now in pain, I bleed. Gaza, please don't bleed tears that much. Gaza, please, when you bleed tears, the earth will form grooves so deep, so much. Gaza, please, hear my prayers for you. Gaza, please, cool down. I love you. Gaza, I love you, hither and thither. Gaza, I feel you yonder like a hot geyser. Gaza, I feel your pain. Gaza, please, understand. I hate your pain. Gaza, I walk with you as I walk with Palestine. Gaza, I walk with you as I walk with Palestine. Gaza, they raped your brains. Gaza, they raped your women. Gaza, they raped your children. Gaza, I walk with you as I walk with Palestine. Gaza, I walk the talk. I don't just talk the talk. Gaza, please, cool down. I know you can't take the pain. Pain is so deep. Gaza, one day you will have freedom. Gaza, one day we have freedom. Brothers and sisters in Islam, let's pray for the people of Palestine, all the children that are in hospitals, all the people that passed away in Palestine since 1948. May Allah bring peace in Palestine. May Allah strengthen the Ummah. May Allah strengthen the people of Palestine and unite the world. May Allah make it easy for us, inshallah, so that we can help all the people that are suffering in Palestine. May Allah strengthen us as Muslimin to make dua for the people of Palestine. Wa akhir da'wana an alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.